My name is Kurt Worley. I'm the quantitative analyst at epicsbootcamp.com, and this is your news alert for Tuesday, May 6, 2008. First, I should clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. We do not make trade recommendations. However, we do conduct technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. Last Thursday, the Chartered Institute of Purchasing and Supply, or CIPS, released the April figure for its Purchasing Managers Index, which represents manufacturing activity in the United Kingdom. That index is very similar to the ISM's Manufacturing Index used to gauge activity in the U.S. manufacturing sector. Today, ISM released its Non-Manufacturing Index, which measures business activity in the U.S. services sector. Tomorrow, CIPS counters with its own measure of service sector activity, this one geared toward the United Kingdom. The movement of the services index over the past 28 months is shown on the graph you now see. Now, just like the other indices based on purchasing manager surveys that I've already mentioned, the baseline for this index is 50, represented by the red dashed line you see on this graph. Readings above 50 indicate economic expansion, and a rising trend in the index tends to be positive for the British pound. On the other hand, a downtrend in the index tends to be negative for the pound. An index reading below 50 would indicate economic contraction in the UK's services sector. That sub 50 level is territory this index hasn't seen in years. But as the graph shows, the threat of this index hitting 50 seems to be getting more and more real with each passing month. In fact, seeing that this index has been a lot closer to 50 over the past 6 months than it was during the prior 22 months made me wonder, has the market noticed this? Is the market now more responsive to this report than it traditionally has been? Well, when I say more responsive, I mean in terms of the movement in the British pound USD currency pair during the hours after this report's release. Well, I conducted some analysis to answer that very question. The first thing I set out to do was divide the historical data into two groups so that I could draw up a sort of a now versus then comparison. Now, I didn't need long to figure out how to segment the data. It seems to me that there was sort of a phase shift, if you will, from the September reading of this index to the October reading. From early 2006 through mid-2007, this index seemed to spend a lot of time around the 58 level. The big drop in the October reading was just the start of a new series of data points hovering not near 58, but instead near about 53. So, there are my two groups. What I did then was I conducted a spike analysis using data provided by NewsTrader Probe. What that means is I've taken the range in pips of the pound during the first minute after the release of this index on each of these 28 months. I plotted those ranges as bars on a graph, which you now see below the original PMI graph. The taller the bar on that lower graph, the bigger the move during the first minute after the release of the index on that particular month. So, I now have each point on the line graph and the bar directly below it on the spike analysis graph, both corresponding to the same month in each case. Do you see a pattern here? Maybe it's just me, but it appears that there's been more volatility in the pound during the minute after this news release over the past 6 months. Everything to the right of the vertical black line, there's been more volatility to the right of the vertical black line than there was for most of the 22 months prior to that time. Now, I took it a step further and I conducted a standard, what the statisticians refer to as a standard t-test, to compare the means of the two groups. Again, kind of the after group, the after the black line, and the before the black line. What I learned was that during the months since the black line, the pound has been moving about 18 pips more. Again, 18 pips more during the first minute after news. Now, that tells me the market moving potential of this report has increased for the British pound USD. And you can now see that in many of the charts for the pound after the more recent news releases. One example of a solid move resulting in a profitable scalp trade was the December index released in early January for this report. 50 pips. It was 50 pips up over the first 3 minutes. And after a better than expected PMI number, the very logical move. move up in the pound USD in response to a better than expected PMI number. If you entered a long trade on the higher high above the first 3 minute candle you see right here, if you entered a long trade on the higher high, you took at least 25 pips profit from the move up if you exited before the New York Open, which occurred just after the extent of this graph here. Not a huge move in comparison to some of the responses to news you'll see from a pair like, say, the pound yen, but my point is this. The recent response of the pound to this report has arguably come a long, long way from the days of last summer, for example, when the trading range over the 3 hours after this news release was less than 25 pips. Forex traders seek volatility, and a 25 pip range certainly will not do it for us. Now, the forecast for tomorrow's report is 51.7, so the market is already expecting a number worse than anything already plotted on the graph that I showed you earlier. It might take a figure close to 50 to produce the bigger red candles we'd like to see if we're looking for a short trade. However, in an upside surprise, say something around or above 54 or near 55 could very likely catch the market by surprise and lead to some big green candles that would be conducive to a long trade. Either way, my analysis suggests that an extreme number from this report is more likely to move the pound than it was at this point last year. Good luck and happy trading. My name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your news alert for Tuesday, May 6, 2008.